Hello everyone and welcome back to the Perfect French with Dylan. Today I have a highly requested lesson for you. We are going to learn the differences between an and année. We are also going to see jour, journée, matin, matinée, and soir, soirée. But we are going to start with an, année, because this is the exact same process for jour, journée, matin, matinée, soir, soirée. Don't forget that if you signed up for my newsletter, the free PDF of this lesson is already in your inbox. If you are not yet signed up for my newsletter, you should, because you get new lesson every Wednesday. To grab this PDF and all the future one, just go to the first comment of this video. You will see a link. Click on the link and just follow the steps. So let's start. The first thing that you have to understand is that un an and une année have different genders. Like everything in French, why would it be the same? So un an is a masculine noun, while une année is a feminine noun. It is going to be the same for all of them, all the ones that we are going to see today. I will come back on it before each one. It's all about precision or approximation. This is all about that. This is very vague, but we also have very specific scenario when we use them. So we are going to see each of them. We are going to start with un an. We are going to use un an for quantities and with numbers. For example, j'ai 34 ans. J'ai 34 ans. So we all know this one. J'ai 34 ans. You cannot say j'ai 34 années. Doesn't work. We can also say il a vécu 10 ans en Guadeloupe. Il a vécu 10 ans en Guadeloupe. So here, this is all about quantity and numbers. For repetitive events, we are also going to use un an. For example, il voyage au Mexique tous les ans. Il voyage au Mexique tous les ans. On passe un week-end ensemble trois fois par an. On passe un week-end ensemble trois fois par an. Also, nothing to do with French, but how do you do three with your hand? Because I do this, but many people do this. So what do you do and where are you from? Because I want to get to the bottom of that. Back to the lesson. So for repetitive events, we are going to use en. Besides chaque année. Chaque année is an exception, but here so tous les ans, trois fois par an, etc., etc. We are going to use en. Now, une année, which is the feminine one. We are going to use une année for quality and length. So before it was quantity, now it's quality. Nous espérons apprendre le français cette année. Nous espérons apprendre le français cette année. Il essaye de faire du sport toute l'année. Il essaye de faire du sport toute l'année. So here we are talking about the length of the year, the quality of it. Another way to remember when to use année is with an adjective. For example, mes parents ont eu une année difficile. Mes parents ont eu une année difficile. I know that I'm gonna get questioned about it. We can also say mes parents ont eu une année difficile. Second one, c'est probablement la meilleure année pour investir. C'est probablement la meilleure année pour investir. Don't take my advice, I'm just a teacher, okay? I told you that we can use en with numbers, but with ordinal numbers, we are going to use année. Il va commencer sa deuxième année. Il va commencer sa deuxième année. So that's for année. Let's see a few expressions while we're here. We have une année scolaire, la bonne année, usually it's souhaiter la bonne année, to wish happy new year, la bonne année. Une année lumière, so that's for the very specific scenario when you have to use one or another. We do have a few times where You can use both. That's really up to you. There's no rule about it. It's going to be with the adjectives prochain, prochaine, dernier, dernière, passé, passé. So you can say l'année prochaine, l'an prochain, l'année dernière, l'an dernier, l'année passée, l'an passé. With those, it's up to you, you can choose the one you want. I usually advise my students to use année with those three, just because then you keep the rule with the adjective and you don't get confused too much. But it's up to you. So you remember, an is basically for quantity, année is for quality. This is very important for the other one that we are going to see now. We are going to start with un jour, une journée. They both mean a day. So, like I said at the beginning, un jour is a masculine noun, une journée is a feminine noun. For the three next, we are going to see everything about quantity and quality. For the quantity, we have un jour, not une journée. Il est parti il y a trois jours. Il est parti il y a trois jours. Or, on a passé 5 jours à Londres. On a passé 5 jours à Londres. Quantity. Now for the quality, which is either good or bad, we have une journée, une journée. Cette journée est interminable. Cette journée est interminable. This day is endless. Or you can say, quelle journée? Quelle journée? What a day. Quality. Now for matin, matinée. Un matin, une matinée. Un matin is masculine noun. Une matinée, feminine noun. Quantity. Le courrier est livré tous les matins. Le courrier est livré tous les matins. Here we can also talk about repetitive events, like I said at the beginning. Or you can say, je lui ai parlé ce matin. Je lui ai parlé ce matin. Quantity. Now if we look at quality, le courrier arrivera pendant la matinée. Le courrier arrivera pendant la matinée. On devrait arriver vers la fin de la matinée. On devrait arriver vers la fin de la matinée. Un soir, une soirée. For the same thing, un soir is a masculine noun. Une soirée is a feminine noun, means an evening. For the quantity, je regarde les informations tous les soirs. Je regarde les informations tous les soirs. Or, on va au restaurant ce soir. On va au restaurant ce soir. And for the last one, we have une soirée quality. Cette soirée était super. Cette soirée était super. Or, on s'est parlé pendant la soirée. On s'est parlé pendant la soirée. That's it for this lesson. I hope that now you can use an, année, jour, journée, matin, matinée, soir, soirée correctly. If you have a doubt, you can always ask me in the comment section. I try to answer my comments every single day. Don't forget to grab your free PDF, subscribe to my channel, like this video if you liked it, it really helped me. And I will see you on Friday for a new short. À vendredi!